Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today we are here for my weeks 29 and 30 update. So let's jump on in to what's been going on with this very out of breath pregnant lady the last 2 weeks. Okay, you guys, I'm sorry, the lighting is really bad. I'm in my basement and it's like getting dark here in Minnesota at like 4:30 p.m. So doing the best with what I got. My camera lights are stuck under the stairs and we have a crawl space and your girl can't get under the stairs because of the belly in the way. So for now, this'll do. Okay, so the biggest things that have been happening in weeks 29 and 30 is I've really noticed that I am hungry, and like hungry as in starving every meal of the day. Breakfast is usually not so bad. I can usually get by with a protein shake still. But for lunch and dinner, oh my gosh, I like have to eat, and it has to be something super filling. So I have been consuming a little bit more carbohydrates than I have been the previous weeks in my pregnancy. I'm just making sure that a lot of those carbs are coming from like whole grains and like brown rice and black beans and pinto beans, what have you. So I've been doing a lot of like taco bowls the past like week and a half. Of course there's Thanksgiving in there too, so I had all the goods on Thanksgiving. Yes, all the carbs. Carbs are life right now. I'm very hungry. In regards to my carpal tunnel, it is just getting worse, you guys. Now, I don't really notice any more fluid retention than what's been going on the previous weeks. Maybe a little bit more I'll notice, like when I take my socks off at night, I can like notice there's like a little bit more of a line or an indent there than usual, but it's nothing crazy. So my carpal tunnel, I don't know why it's getting worse. My doctor says it's just because my fluids, everything is just a flowing, and it's really common right now. My mini Aussie Aspen is joining us for today's video. Yeah, you go girl. She just had puppies herself this summer, so she's looking a little straggly. She lost all of her hair, all of her fur, just like humans do. Dogs lose their fur after they have puppies. I didn't know that. Okay, other symptoms that I have been noticing besides the hunger and the increased carpal tunnel, which by the way, is the worst when, like as soon as I get up, I have to brush my teeth like this. Just like in the little indent of my thumb and my finger. Otherwise, like when I'm driving, I'll notice my hands will go numb as I put my hands on the steering wheel. Or today, a good example was I was holding my big like flat of like candles from the Bath & Body Works candle day sale. And I stood in line for like 20 minutes. My hands were like absolutely numb by the end of it. It was ridiculous, but totally manageable. It's just more or less laughable at this point. Other things that I have been noticing is I'm very tired. I get out of breath easily. The out of breath and the getting tired, I guess, aren't necessarily going hand in hand. There's a baby in my lungs, so it's really hard for me to take like normal breaths. So that's why I'm out of breath. But I'm so tired by the end of the day, I can't keep my eyes open unless I'm having like an afternoon a little coffee or tea or something, well within my caffeine range. But I mean, I'm just so tired, I can't help it. Usually I'll come home and I'll work on a couple signs and make dinner, get Kaya ready for bed, get ready for the next day. And I just can't do it anymore because I'm so tired. I just gotta rest my eyes. Okay, so moving into kind of that tiredness, I have been experiencing a lot of Braxton Hicks. The contractions, the Braxton Hicks contractions have been real, you guys. Like even this past week, which I'm 32 weeks now, I'm running a couple weeks behind. I'm trying to get caught up for you guys. I've really noticed that like my tummy just will not relax. It will not relax. So I did bring that up to my doctor, actually my nurse practitioner is who I saw this time. I brought that up and she just said that, you know, your uterus is a muscle just like any other muscle. So by the end of the day, it's tired and it just needs to relax. So I have strict orders from my doctor to relax at night and just kick my feet up. I tend to overdo it just because we do kind of have a chaotic life. So I tend to overdo it at night, and I'm working until, you know, 9, 10 p.m., go to sleep, and then I'll start it all over again at 6 a.m. the next day. So I've had to really cut down on the amount of signs that I'm doing. You guys, I forget how hard the end of pregnancy can be. This pregnancy has been so wonderful, and it hasn't been until like the past couple weeks that I've just said, you know what? I gotta throw in the towel. I am pregnant. Okay, so my Braxton Hicks contractions. Now, Braxton Hicks should never, they should not last longer than like a half hour. So like if you're getting them, and they should be irregular as well. So if you're getting irregular contractions for like less than a half hour, those are Braxton Hicks. But I was experiencing, it was the night before my 30-week appointment, I was experiencing Braxton Hicks contractions that were timable and were lasting, that were coming like every 2.5 minutes, and it lasted for about 2.5 hours. And it wasn't anything, like I wasn't in pain, I just was really uncomfortable. I could tell that they weren't, like they weren't really crampy, it was just more or less like pinching and like tightening, but they were timable. So I let my doctor know about that as well, and they said the next time that that happens, I do need to go into labor and delivery so that we can stop the contractions. I learned as well that my hospital will only stop your contractions up to 35 or 36 weeks. If you go past that point, you're having contractions and it looks like you're in early labor past 35, 36 weeks, they'll let you go. In my head the whole time I was thinking that was 37 weeks, but 35 or 36 weeks. So if this little guy decides to come early, which let's all laugh right now because I bet you he'll come like a week late still, even though I never had contractions with Kaya, my daughter, and then I went to like 42 and a half weeks. But I don't know. I hope like I have a 38 week delivery. I go natural, as in like I don't need to be induced, because everybody has their own opinions, but I needed the epidural last time and I think I'm going to need it this time. Side story on that, I will be uploading Kaya's birth story for you guys. I just need to write everything down on paper, and I have recorded it once before in the past, but it was like terrible, terrible video quality and the lighting was like bright yellow. It was really awkward. So I need to just collect my thoughts, write everything down. All right, anyway, so I will be uploading that for you guys. Sometime within the next few days here for Vlogmas. I'm really excited to share that birth story with you guys because honestly, it was incredible. I had a failed epidural. It only was working on the outside. but anything helps when it comes to labor pain. So I was very grateful to at least not have to feel those contractions. But stay tuned for more on that. So that's what's been going on past couple weeks. It's been a crazy whirlwind. We had a funeral, we had a death in the family, unfortunately, and then we had Thanksgiving, so we hosted guests for 2 weeks straight, and you know what, I forget I'm pregnant sometimes, and it's not until I get winded and I get so tired that I need to take a nap that I remember that I'm pregnant. All right, you guys, well, that is going to wrap up my 29 and 30 week bump date. He is a little ninja. He's going crazy. He's kicking me, he's rolling, and he's getting ready to make his appearance here, hopefully sometime in the next 8 weeks or so. We will see. I have lots of fun videos planned for you guys this month. I am doing Vlogmas, but I'm not doing vlogs per se every single day. I will be doing some kind of video for you guys, most of which are sit-down videos. But if you like the vlog style videos on my channel, make sure you go back and give those a big thumbs up for me so I know you like those videos on my channel. If you have any video requests, leave them down below and I will do my best to accommodate. And I'm excited, you guys. I've never done Vlogmas, so. All right, you guys, thanks so much for tuning in today. Make sure you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on my Vlogmas videos. Turn on your bell notifications so you don't miss when I upload. Usually I will upload at 8 a.m. or 4 or 5 p.m. Those are the times that I will typically upload a video. And I will see you guys sometime in the very near future. And we'll end today's video with another bump shot. Okay, bye, guys. guys.